Good morning. Today we'll start with pressure and fluid statics. In this chapter, forces applied by fluids at rest or in rigid body motion are discussed. The fluid property responsible for these forces is pressure, which is normal force exerted by a fluid per unit area. We start this chapter with a detailed discussion of pressure, including absolute and gauge pressure. The pressure at a point, the variation of pressure with depth in a gravitational field, the manometer, the barometer, and pressure measurement devices. So this is followed by discussion of hydrostatic forces applied on submerged bodies with plane or curved surface. We then consider the buoyancy force applied by fluids on submerged or floating bodies. Finally, we apply Newton's second law of motion to a body of fluid in motion that acts as a rigid body and analyze the variation of pressure in fluids that undergo linear acceleration and in rotating containers. So this chapter makes extensive use of force balances for bodies in static equilibrium, and it will be helpful if the relevant topics from statics are first viewed. Pressure at a point. Pressure is compressive force per unit area, and it gives the impression of being a vector. However, pressure at any point in a fluid is same in all directions. That is, it has magnitude but not a specific direction, and thus it is a scalar quantity. This can be demonstrated by considering a small wedge-shaped fluid element of unit length in equilibrium as shown in figure. So this is your wedge-shaped fluid element. From downward side, P2 pressure is applied. From this side, say pressure is P1, and from this wedge element, which is I, the pressure is P3, inclined surface. So this height is del z, this horizontal distance is del x, and del y is taken equal to 1. Now if this element is in equilibrium, apply the force balance, means force at the x, which is equal to 0. In the force in z direction must be 0 if this wedge has to be in equilibrium. So this force P1 into del z must be balanced by the horizontal component of P3, which is P3 sin theta, and the force in the z direction is balanced by, that is Fz, which is P2 del x by the this vertical component of P3. So P1 del z minus P3 I sin theta is equal to, I represents inclined surface 0, and in z direction, that is P2 del x minus P3 I cos theta minus weight of this element. Now weight of this element is, as you can see, this is a triangle shape, y is 1, del y is 1. So it is multiplication of this base into height into half into this del y into density into gravity. So this is your weight of this wedge element. Now this is the inclined surface. Find del x in terms of inclined surface. That is, del x is equal to I cos theta and del z is equal to I sin theta. So substituting these geometric relations and dividing by del z, we will get P1 minus P3 equal to 0, and we will get P2 minus P3 minus half into density into gravity of del z is equal to 0. The last term in equation drops out as del z tends to 0, and the wedge becomes inferential, and thus the fluid element shrinks to a point. Then combining the results of these two relations gives P1 is equal to P2 is equal to P3 is equal to P. When you solve this, you will get all pressure equal. So regardless of the angle theta, we can repeat this analysis for an element in XYZ plane and obtain a similar result. Thus we conclude that pressure at a point in a fluid has the same magnitude in all directions. It can be shown in the absence of shear force that this result is applicable to fluids in motion as well as fluids at rest. Introduction to fluid statics. Fluid statics deals with problem associated with fluids at rest. The fluid can be better understood as gases or liquid. Fluid statics is generally referred to as hydrostatics when the fluid is a liquid, and as aerostatics when the fluid is a gas. In fluid statics, there is no relative motion with adjacent fluid layers, and thus there are no shear stress in the fluid trying to deform it. The only stress we will deal with the fluid statics is normal stress, which is the pressure. and the variation of pressure is due only to the weight of the fluid. Therefore, the topic of fluid statics has significance only in gravity fields, and the force relations develop naturally involve the gravitational acceleration g. The force exerted on a surface by a fluid at rest is normal to the surface at a point of contact, since there is no relative motion between the fluid and the solid surface, and thus no shear forces can act parallel to the surface. Fluid statics is used to determine the forces acting on floating or submerged bodies and the forces developed by devices like hydraulic presses and car jacks. The design of many engineering systems such as water dams and liquid storage tanks require the determination of forces acting on the surfaces using fluid statics. The completion description of the resultant hydrostatic force acting on a submerged surface requires the determination of magnitude, the direction, and the line of action of the force. In section, we consider the force acting on both plane and curved surface of submerged body due to pressure. Hydrostatic forces on a submerged plane surface. So, a plane exposed to a liquid such as gate valve in dam, the wall of a liquid storage tank, or the hull of a ship at rest is subjected to fluid pressure distributed over its surface. On a plate surface, the hydrostatic force form a system of parallel forces, and we often need to determine the magnitude of the force and its point of application, which is called the center of pressure. In most cases, the other side of plate is open to the atmosphere, and thus atmosphere pressure acts on both sides of plate, yielding a zero resultant. In such cases, it is convenient to subtract atmosphere pressure and work with the gauge pressure only. For example, P gauge is equal to rho gh at the bottom of the lake. Consider the top surface of a flat plate of an arbitrary shape completely submerged in a liquid as shown in figure. So you can see this is your hydrostatic force on a submerged surface. Atmospheric pressure can be subtracted for simplicity when it acts on both sides. So this is your atmosphere pressure on this side and this side. So this is the height of the fluid, and the total weight is acted on this surface here at the lowest part is rho gh. Now the absolute pressure above the liquid is P naught, which is the local atmosphere pressure, P atmosphere, if the liquid is open to the atmosphere, but P naught may be different. Now take a plate. This is the plate which is submerged under the liquid. We have to find the forces on this plate due to this liquid and atmosphere. Now this plate is submerged here at some inclination angle, that is theta, and distance here is y. So you can see this y, this is the y axis here. So this y, you can say take a small area dA here, which is y distance from this z axis. So C is the center of the plate, Cp is the center of pressure. Now this is the height of the point, this is the area here dA, this is the height of the, you can say, water above this area, that is h, this is theta. So you can find if this element is y, if this element is y, so this will be y sin theta here. Now P is equal to P naught plus rho g, where P naught is atmosphere pressure and rho h is your pressure due to height. Now rho g h is equal to rho g y sin theta, where h is the vertical distance of the point from the free surface and y is the distance of the point from the x-axis. The resultant hydrostatic force acting on the surface is determined by integrating the force P dA acting on the differential area dA over the entire surface area. So total resultant force, which is FR, so this total resultant force is the integration of this small area. If you calculate the force on this small area and if you integrate it, you will get total force. So this is the pressure P, which is on this small area dA, that is P, multiplied by this small area dA, and when you integrate, you will get total force. So P is or P naught plus rho g by sin theta. So after integration you will get this P naught A plus rho g y sin theta, rho g sin theta into integration of y dA. Now this is y dA here is for this dA element. Now we assume the whole the force will act at the centroid. So means instead of y we have to calculate for the this centroid, because whole force is assumed to act at the center centroid of the, you can say, this plate. So when you integrate this, when you integrate this yda, first moment of area of yda is related to y coordinate of the centroid of the surface, which is equal to yc. So yc is equal to 1 by a integration of yda, which will become equal to total area of the plate. So instead of here integral of yda, you can write total area of the plate. So substituting the values, the fr is equal to p naught plus rho g yc here sin theta into area. So p naught plus rho g hc into area. Now here hc is equal to this height hc, and as we know this is the y, this is theta, and this distance is your yc, that is the distance from the centroid, because the whole pressure or the height which we have to consider is from the centroid. So this is your centroid of surface. So hc, this yc sin theta become equal to hc, and you will get this pressure here. Now also we know the pressure will increase. At this point pressure is lower, at this point pressure is maximum, but because we have to take the centroid of surface, so this average pressure, this average pressure we will take, and this average pressure is equal to, say, PC, pressure at centroid. Now this pressure at centroid is equal to this pressure. So this, because this is calculation for centroid, pressure at the centroid, so this we can write as PC, or we can write average pressure. So which the force, resultant force is equal to P average into area. PC is equal to P naught plus density into gravity into HC is the pressure at centroid of surface, which is equal to the average pressure on the surface, and HC is equal to, this HC is equal to YC sin theta is the vertical distance of the centroid from the free surface of the liquid. The magnitude of the resultant force acting on plane surface of a completely submerged plate in a homogeneous fluid is equal to the product of the pressure PC at the centroid of the surface and the area A of the surface, which is PC into A. So this is the area of the plate, multiply whatever the pressure at the centroid, that is PC. So this will give you the resultant force. So this is about hydrostatic force on submerged plate surface. Like this video, subscribe this channel, and thank you for watching this video.